Hey, church family. I was reading this week about a construction crew that had been on the job site for about a week when one of the men was hurt and a new guy named Jason was hired. Jason was a broad-shouldered, powerful young man and a really good worker, but he was also very annoying. Jason was always bragging that he was stronger than anyone else at the work site, and he especially made fun of one of the older workers named Ralph. Finally, the old fellow had had enough. "Sonny," said Ralph, "why don't you put your money where your mouth is? I'll bet you a week's wages that I can haul something in a wheelbarrow over to that outbuilding that you will not be able to wheel back." Jason smiled and said, "You're on, old man. Let's see what you got." Then Ralph reached out, grabbed the wheelbarrow by the handles, then nodding to Jason, he said, "All right, young man, get in." There are a lot of applications to this story, but it reminds us that there are all kinds of burdens. Some are physical, others are emotional or mental. The Bible calls us to bear one another's burdens and so fulfill the law of Christ. And the thing about burdens is, we never really know what kind of burdens others are bearing. As I was thinking about that, I was reminded of an event that happened 13 years ago. The date was August 1st, 2007. It was a typical afternoon commute across the I-35 West Bridge in Minneapolis, and it sadly turned tragic when suddenly, and without warning, the bridge collapsed into the Mississippi River below. 13 people died, and 145 were injured. Frankly, it was amazing that so many people whose vehicles plunged into the river survived. The thing about bridges is that the vast majority of us never give a moment's thought to whether or not they're structurally sound. We simply drive across them. It's such a matter of trust for us that we don't even consider the possibility that they might not be safe. I want to challenge you to think of the many people around you every day, including the people who make up your world of relationships. Most of us don't give a moment's thought as to what's going on in the lives of those around us. Yet many people are carrying burdens that few, if any of us, can see. Like an unsound bridge that looks normal, but is critically damaged in places unseen, most appear as though all is well in their lives, yet some teeter at the brink of collapse from the wounds that have weakened them. In the Minneapolis bridge collapse, heroes emerged. People caught on the collapsed bridge and rescue workers who quickly arrived on the scene were quick to help. These folk courageously put their own lives at risk to help those caught in the tragedy. It's a great reminder that we, as Christ followers, are called to be spiritual and emotional rescue workers in the lives of those around us. In the New Testament book of Jude, we read, "Show mercy to those whose faith is wavering. Rescue others by snatching them from the flames of judgment." There's still others to whom you need to show mercy. Today, let me challenge you to do your best to look below the surface of the lives of the people around you. Chances are there's someone you know who needs your support. Through your love and care, you can help to prevent someone from suffering collapse. There's some things we just can't handle ourselves. We need someone else, which is why God has called us to bear one another's burdens, and by doing that, fulfill the law of Christ. Amen.